दुरूद पाक पढ़ लीजिए, सलात व सलाम अलैहि अभी हमारी महफिल के इंतहाई खूबसूरत मेहमान कि जिनको आप अक्सर व बेशतर महफिल मुस्तफा के अंदर सुनते रहते हैं और हमारे नौजवानों के दिलों की धड़कन हैं, आलम बाअमल हैं, इंतहाई अच्छे अंदाज में दीन मतीन की खिदमत का फरीजा जो है वो अंजाम दे रहे हैं। मेरी मुराद हजरत अल्लामा मौलाना मोहम्मद अरशद साहब मिसबाही दामत बरकातुल आलिया से है। मैं उनकी खिदमत में मुअद्दबाना इल्तिमास करता हूँ कि वो माइक पर तशरीफ लाते हैं और अपने मखसूस अंदाज में प्यारे आका मौला सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वालैहि वसहाबिही वबारक वसल्लम की बारगाह में हदिया तबरीक पेश करते हैं। आप सभी हजरात भी मोहब्बत से नारा लगा दीजिए, नाराए तकबीर, नाराए रिसाल, नाराए रिसाल। जरा पीछे से आवाज कम आ रही है, आप भी बोलिए नाराए रिसाल, महफिले मुस्तफा, उलमाए मुस्तफा, उलमाए अहले सुन्नत।
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وذكرهم بأيام الله صدق الله مولانا العظيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد معدن الجود والكرم وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا سيدي يا رحمة للعالمين الله رب محمد صلى عليه وسلم نحن عباد محمد صلى عليه وسلم عجب رنگ پر ہے بہار مدینہ अजब रंग पर है बहारे मदीना कि सब जन्नते हैं निसारे मदीना कि सब जन्नते हैं निसारे मदीना और बना आसमां मंजिले इब्ने मरियम बना आसमां मंजिले इब्ने मरियम गए लामका ताजदारे मदीना गए लामका ताजदारे मदीना और मलाइक लगाते हैं आंखों में अपनी मलाइक लगाते हैं आंखों में अपनी शबो रोज खाके मजारे मदीना शबो रोज खाके मजारे मदीना और मेरी खाक या रब न बर्बाद जाए मेरी खाक या रब न बर्बाद जाए पसे मर्ग कर दे गुबारे मदीना पसे मर्ग कर दे गुबारे मदीना और शरफ जिनसे हासिल हुआ अंबिया को शरफ जिनसे हासिल हुआ अंबिया को वही है हसन इफ्तिखारे मदीना वही है हसन इफ्तिखारे मदीना अजब रंग पर है बहारे मदीना कि सब जन्नते हैं निसारे मदीना। الحمدللہ تبارک و تعالی Allah has truly blessed us with the ability of coming together in this beautiful masjid celebrating the Milad of Aqa alayhi salatu wassalam and more importantly in the night that he sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam graced the world. What more could you ask for? In the mahfil of the beloved, commemorating his holy and blessed birth, I pray from the depths of my heart that Allah blesses each and every one of us with the fuse and barakat of this auspicious night. Many, many great scholars, muhaddisun, imams of Islam are of the opinion that the night of the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam is greater in its importance and significance than the night of Laylatul Qadr. And you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly mentions in the Quran Majeed when he says Laylatul Qadr khairun min alf shahr, the night of power is better than 1,000 months. But the lives of Sayyidina Shah Abdul Haq Muhaddis Dehlvi, Hazrat Imam Zarqani and other great muhaddisun, they are of the opinion that the night of the Prophet's birth is greater than the Laylatul Qadr. Why? Because we, the Ummah of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, we have been blessed with the Laylatul Qadr. Why? Because we are the Ummah of Aqa alayhi salatu wassalam. And it is because of his birth, because of his coming to this dunya, that Allah gave us a night that is as great as Laylatul Qadr. So be proud, celebrate, commemorate, rejoice, hold such functions, have these beautiful spiritual gatherings, for you will see the true benefits of such gatherings inshallah in the hereafter. Hazrat Shaykh Muhakkik Shah Abdul Haq Muhaddis Dehlvi, an outstanding scholar of Islam, a great muhaddis who is credited for bringing the science of hadith to the Indian subcontinent, an outstanding figure, and every sect of Islam and Muslims looks up to him. You know what is his opinion about celebrating Milad and reciting Salatu Salam in this night? Hazrat Shah Abdul Haq Muhaddis Dehlvi Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi, he says in the court of Allah in Akhbarul Akhyar Sharif, he writes, O Allah, I have no amal, I have no deed that is free from ostentation. There is nothing I can present in your court
that I can be proud of, that I can seek your forgiveness because of that deed. But he goes on to say, Ya Allah, but there is one amal. There is one deed. There is one practice of mine. That I, Abdul Haq Dehlvi, on the night of the Milad of Aqa Ali Salatu Wasalam, I stand up and I recite Salatu Wasalam on the beloved Ali Salatu Wasalam. And I am truly hopeful that on the day of judgment, my maghfirat will take place because of this amal of mine. Subhanallah. What a great scholar teaching us the importance of celebrating this night. And this is the night that all nights and all days are because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose this night for the blessed birth of Aqa alayhi salatu wasalam. If it wasn't for this night, if it wasn't for this night, we would not be here. We would not have been created. And not only us, nothing in the universe would exist. Even the likes of the great thinker of the East, Allama Iqbal, he says, Ho na ye phool, to bulbul ka tarannum bhi na ho. Chamane dahr mein kaliyon ka tabassum bhi na ho. ये ना साकी हो तो फिर मैं भी ना हो, खुन भी ना हो, बजने तौहीद भी दुनिया में ना हो, तुम भी ना हो। खैमा अफलाक का इस्तादा इसी नाम से है, नब्ज़े हस्ती तपिश आमादा इसी नाम से है, कुव्वते इश्क से हर पस्त को बाला कर दे, दहर में इसमें मोहम्मद से उजाला कर दे, कि मोहम्मद से वफा तूने तो हम
Allah.
You know who he says this for? This is Jawab-e-Shikwa. This is the last couplet of Jawab-e-Shikwa. He is saying this from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah says to the universe, O people, Ki Muhammad se wafa tu ne, to hum tere hai. Ye jahan cheez hai kya, lauho kalam tere hai. Ye jahan cheez hai kya, lauho kalam tere hai. He says, if it wasn't for the Prophet Ali Salatu Wasalam, we would not exist. Allah would not have declared His rububiyat. Allah would not have revealed His being the Lord. It is down to the Prophet Sallallahu Ta'ala Alayhi Wa Alayhi Wa Sallam. And it is about such occasions that Allah commands in the Holy Quran, in the blessed, incomplete verse that I have had the honor to recite from Surah Ibrahim, Allah says, وَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. This is the command of Allah. And we know as Muslims that every command of Allah, every hukm of Allah, of any do's and don'ts, there is great hikmah behind it. There are beautiful reasons behind why Allah tells us to do something and why Allah commands us not to do anything. In this verse of the Quran, Allah gives us a hukm. Allah gives us a rule. And what is that? He says, وَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. Remind them, Allah says, remind them of Allah's days. Unhe Allah ke dinon ki yaad dilao. What does this mean? Why does Allah say this in the Quran? Outwardly, seemingly, does it mean that we are to tell each other, my dear brother, today is a Monday. Tomorrow is going to be a Tuesday. Yesterday was a Sunday. Is that what Allah tells us to do? These verses of the Quran are best mufassirun, those who spend their lifetimes in trying to understand the Quran. And who is the greatest of all mufassirun? The Imam Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala. He is that personality that Aqa Ali Salatu Wassalam himself made dua for Abdullah ibn Abbas. And what was the dua? The Prophet Ali Salatu Wassalam says, Allahumma allimhu ta'wil. Oh, the Prophet Ali Salatu Wassalam said about him, Allahumma allimhu al-kitab. Allah's Rasul prays in the court of the Creator. And he says, oh Allah, give the true knowledge of the Quran and the understanding of the essence of the Quran to Abdullah ibn Abbas. Sayyidul Mufassirin, Imamul Mufassirin. His tafsir will of course be the best of all tafsir. He comments like many other great Sahaba and Tabi'een and Imams. He says, what does it mean when Allah says, Zakkirhum bi ayyamillah? Remind them of the days of Allah. He comments, he makes tafsir that the days of Allah are those days and nights where Allah Ta'ala sent down his most beautiful in'amat upon the creation. His bounties, his gifts, his favors. Whenever Allah has revealed any special favor upon his creation, Allah commands that you must remind each other of those days, of those special days. For example, the day when Hazrat Sayyiduna Musa alayhi salam and his followers were set free from the wrath and the torments of Fir'aun and his army. These are in Ayyamillah. The day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised Sayyiduna Isa alayhi salam to the heavens. These are in Ayyamillah. The day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave safety to Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam, these are min ayyamillah. Ask yourself this question, my brothers and sisters. Is there any day, any night, which is greater than the night and the day in which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to this dunya? Is he not the greatest ni'mat of Allah? Is he not the greatest bounty of Allah? That is why, alhamdulillah, the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah have this practice. We inform each other, we remind each other, we tell our future generations that 12th of Rabi'ul Awwal Sharif is the day when Rasulullah graced the universe in the form of a human being. It's following the command of the Quran. Quran says remind, and Quran also says, in the last verse of Surah Al-Duha, وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. In this ayat from Surah Ibrahim, what does Allah say? تَذْكِيرَ وَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. Reminder of Al-Yami Allah. In this ayat from Surah Al-Duha, Allah says, and proclaim and rehearse the bounties of Allah. Allah ki ni'maton ka khoob khoob charcha karo. Command of Allah. Charcha karo uski ni'maton ka. Jab bhi Allah ki ni'mat mile uska zikr karo. Uska charcha karo. Tahdees e ni'mat Allah ka hukm hai. Rasulullah is the greatest ni'mat. Rasulullah is undoubtedly the biggest ni'mat, ni'mat-e-uzma, ni'mat-e-kubra of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If it wasn't for the Prophet, would you have Islam? If it wasn't for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would you have the Quran? If it wasn't for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would we have known Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No, Allah Hazrat says, Ey Raza, faiz hai ye Ahmad-e-Pak ka. Ey Raza, faiz hai ye Ahmad-e-Pak ka. Varna hum kya samajte, Khuda kaun hai? Varna hum kya samajte, Khuda, who led us to Allah? Allah Hazrat again says, Ba Khuda, Khuda ka yahi hai dar. बखुदा खुदा का यही है दर, नहीं और कोई मफर मकर, जो वहां से हो यहीं आके हो, जो यहां नहीं तो वहां नहीं। Unless you come to the doors to the of the Prophet Ali Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, there is no way you can lead yourself to the court of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. He is the one and only channel. He is the one and only route. He is the one and only path now until the day of judgment to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Man yuti'ir rasul faqad ata'a Allah. Quran makes it very clear. Quran makes it very clear. So irfan and true knowledge of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is the essence of our deen. You know him, you know deen. You respect him, you respect deen. You make itaat of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, you are making itaat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, realize this. We commemorate this day and we should. We should. जमाने भर का ये कायदा है कि जिसका खाना उसी का गाना। हम सरकार का खाते हैं, हम सरकार का खाते हैं। रब है मोती ये है कासिम, रब है मोती ये है कासिम, रिज उसका है खिलाते ये है, ठंडा ठंडा मीठा मीठा पीते हम है पिलाते ये है, पीते हम है पिलाते ये है। वट एवर वी हैव Even on the day of judgment, Allah Hazrat paints a picture. He says, Ma jab iklote se bhaage, Ma jab iklote se bhaage, aa aa kahke bulate ye hain. And your mothers will leave you. Who will come to your help? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wallahi lazim, you can never ever do justice to the ihsan and to the in'am that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam has on this ummah. Never, impossible, out of the question. The first thing when he comes into this dunya, what does he do? He falls into sajda and he asks for forgiveness of his ummah. Allah Azhar says, pehle sajde pe roze azal se durood. पहले सजदे पे रोजे अजल से दुरूद, यादगारी ये उम्मत पे लाखों सलाम, यादगारी ये उम्मत। इवन देन ही डिड नॉट फॉरगेट अस, as soon as he comes into this world as a human being, remember this, as a human being, I need to make it very clear for the youngsters here, you are celebrating the milad, the birth, the physical coming, as a human being, of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, to the planet Earth. Otherwise, his actual origin, his khilqat, his beginning in the form of a noor, it was when there was nothing. There was no time. There was no space. There was no arsh. There was no kursi. There was no. Nothing but nothing existed, only and only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah wanted to begin creation, He began it first and foremost with the creation of the Noor of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He came to the earth as a human being, as a bashar. Bashar to wo zarur hai, magar hai afzalul bashar. What kind of a bashar was he? Subhanallah. You know, on the night of Miraj, Allahu Akbar, today the Wahhabiyah stress on his bashariyat. Oh, he's a bashar, he's a human being. He had everything like we do, all requirements, all needs, bodily features. But do you know his bashariyat? Allahu Akbar. When Sayyiduna Jibreel Amin, on the night of Miraj, when his nuraniyat with all his powers come to an end, at the Sidratul Muntaha, when he gives up and he says, MashaAllah, Nare Takbir, Nare Risalat, Nare Risalat. When the Nurani power of Jibreel comes to an end and he He says, no, danoto annelatan nahtarakto. Ya Rasulullah, if I move any further than this, I will be burnt. My body, my being cannot tolerate beyond this point, the anwar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is it. Jibreel's power of nuraniyat comes to an end. Rasulullah continues as a bashar. That is the bashar that he was. Jibreel rahe, burak thake, raf raf bhi aage ja na sake. Jibreel rahe, burak thake, raf raf bhi aage ja na sake. Rab udno minni habibi kahe, tere qurb khuda ka kya kehna. Rab udno minni. Jibreel gives up. Burak gives up. Raf raf gives up. Rasulullah continues. Rasulullah continues to where? I can't tell you. Nobody knows. Thumma dana fatadalla. That's what the Quran says. Thumma dana fatadalla. Allah ne kaha na? Usi Nawaz Sharif ka sher hai. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa barik wa sallim. सच्ची बात सिखाते ये हैं, सीधी राह चलाते ये हैं। कसरे दना तक किसकी रसाई, कसरे दना तक किसकी रसाई, जाते ये हैं आते ये हैं, जाते ये हैं आते ये हैं, जाते ये हैं। यू नो व्हाई? सैयदना मूसा अलैहि सलाम, अकीदा अल सुन्ना, अंबिया, इवन आफ्टर देयर डिमाइस, their mouth, mouth comes to them, yes, no doubt, but for a very short time. Within the blink of an eye, Allah says, Anbiya ko bhi ajal aani hai, magar itni ke fakat aani hai, phir us aan ke baad unki hayat misle sabik wahi jismani hai. Musa al-Islam came to the help of this ummah. From 50, we are left with 5. Those who say they can't help, they're finished, they're intermingled with the earth. Instead of 5 salats, they should be doing 50. Who helped us to bring it down to 5? Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. Subhanallah. Kasre dana tak kiski rasai. Jate ye hain, aate ye hain. Subhanallah. Jate ye hain. This is the bashar. Bashariyat aspect of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So he came, my brother and sister, let me conclude. He came to the dunya as a human being, to be the best of all guides, the best of all examples for all mankind until the last day. Until the day of judgment, the Prophet ﷺ is the supreme leader. He is the one who has been blessed with the title of Uswa Hasana from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. Indeed, there is for you in the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam the best of all examples. The best of all examples. You know, we make this da'wah. We are Ashiqi Rasul. We are the lovers of Rasulullah. We are the ghulams of Rasulullah. We make da'wahs and we make nares. Ghulamiye Rasul mein maut bhi qubool hai. I am very sorry to say this, but I think that's only restricted from here. How many of us would die for deen? How many of us will die for Islam? How many of us would really give great sacrifices for this great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? True love, my brothers and sisters, forgive me. True love is shown in your deeds, in your practice, in your character, in your behavior. How you lead your day and night. There is not a single second in the life of a Muslim, if he truly knows Quran and Sunnah, where he or she feels unguided. The Prophet ﷺ's life is so perfect, so matchless, so unique. No matter what you go through in your life, there is an example for you in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we have to follow. We have to show that we truly love him. Do we practice his way of life? Do we follow in his footsteps? Do we eat like him? Do we walk like him? Do we talk like him? Do we see like him? Do we hear like him? Do we smile like him? The Prophet Ali Salatu Wasalam Sahaba say, we never saw anybody who smiled more than the Prophet Ali Salatu Wasalam. Subhanallah. Always tabassum. Always tabassum on the chehre and Anwar of Aqa Ali Salatu Wasalam. Do we behave like that? The Prophet Ali Salatu Wasalam, his life is an example for us. Whatever he did to teach us. He did that to teach, whatever he did. Even sometimes when you feel that mentioning in the ahadith that the Prophet forgot something, for example. For example, in the salah, he had to do sajda sahw. He forgot something. You know what that was? Because he was a teacher for us. So he could teach us. He says, La ansa walakin unsa. I do not forget. I am caused to forget so that it becomes a teaching for you. Hadith Paak ke sarkar ne farmaya, main bhulta nahi hu. Mujhe bhulaya jata hai. Taaki meri bhul bhi tumhare liye baise taalim ban jaye. Baise example ban jaye. Whatever the Prophet did, my brothers and sisters, it's an example for us. That's the need of the day. Milad Sharif ko banane ka asl maqsad kya hai? Allama Masood Qadri sahab ne hamari is masjid ki intizamiya ne aap mujhe baar baar yahan dekhte alhamdulillah bahut aana hota mera aur main baar baar yahi taqeed karta hu ki zarurat is amr ki hai ki hum sacche maane mein haqeeqatan sarkar ki jo mohabbat ka hum daawa karte hain yaqeenan mohabbat hai ye mohabbat hi to aap yahan baithe na मोहब्बत बाकी आप घरों में होते हैं, बिस्तर में होते हैं, टीवी के सामने होते हैं, इंटरनेट पे होते हैं, ये मोहब्बत है जो आपको खींच के लाई है। सुभान अल्लाह। सरकार के जिक्र की महफिल आप तशरीफ लाए, मोहब्बत है, लेकिन ट्रू मोहब्बत, रियल मोहब्बत हैज टू बी शोन इन योर आमाल, इन योर डीड्स। यू नो ब्यूटीफुल, लेट मी सम अप अ ब्यूटीफुल एग्जांपल दैट कम्स टू माइंड फ्रॉम सूरा यूनुस वर्स नंबर 16. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the very early stages of Islam, when he gives an open invitation to the mushriks and the people of Makkah to Islam and Tawheed and Risalat and Nubuwwat, at one stage they say to him, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, why should we believe you are the messenger of Allah? What's so outstanding about you? What can you show to prove your Nubuwwat and Risalat? If Rasulullah wanted, Allah would have showed them any kind of mu'jiza. The Rasul who can make pebbles speak, he could have shown them that mu'jiza. The Rasul who can split the moon, he could have shown them that mu'jiza. The Rasul who can command animals to walk to him and to speak to him, he could have shown them that mu'jiza. The Rasul who, with the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, gave life to inanimate objects, he could have shown them that mu'jiza. But what did he show? In the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, O people, if you want to see my dalil of nubuwwat and risalat and tawheed of Allah, my dalil is my life. My life, 40 years I've spent within you. Quran says, فَقَدْ لَبِثْتُ فِيكُمْ عُمُرًا مِّن قَبْلِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. मैंने तुम में एक उम्र गुजारी है इससे पहले, क्या तुम अक्ल नहीं रखते? मेरी जिंदगी को देखो। Look at my life from the beginning, from the day I was born, to my age today, which is 40. 40 years, my brothers and sisters. 40 years, subhanallah. And on his first da'wat, when he says, oh people, what is your opinion about me? What did they say? مَا جَرَّبْنَا عَلَيْكَ إِلَّا صِدْقًا. Oh Muhammad, 40 years we have seen you, you only speak the truth. 40 years, you only speak the truth. See, the Prophet proved himself first. First he became the living Quran. First he became the, from head to toe, he became the living Quran. And after the age of 40, he gave the world the Quran al-Majeed. That's what we need to do. That's what we need to understand. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me and all of us the tawfiq. Wa akhiru da'wana. Alhamdulillah.